three things. Sorry, my video got cut off while I was speaking on the bench pressing every day. But that was pretty much it, so I didn't want to do an extra video. So sorry for the inconvenience of the video having been cut abruptly. And now we're going to speak on the deadlift. The deadlift, however, has been quite sustainable. And I would say it's fun to do. I like it, you know. The same problem I've had with the bench press every time I started benching. I never kept up with it. So now I think I have enough momentum to keep the deadlift. I start liking it because I think my main issue was the movement part, the technique, the form. I was using way too much of my lower back as my butt shoot first. But working with a lightweight and doing it every day, which is a good thing about doing something every day. I mean, your nervous system get accustomed to it, so it becomes part of you, the movement. So that's what I did, and now the form is not impeccable, but it's quite clean. Yeah, I'm impressed by myself, because even when I go fairly heavy, what I consider heavy, because 4-5 to me, I gotta tell you, it's heavy. I know how people do this shit and underestimate 4-5, but for me, for now, it's heavy. So, because if I don't perform the way with as clean form as I can, to me, I don't go up. So that's why I'm sticking to 4-5, and 4-5 is dreadful. And the fact that I can't do 4-5 with overhand, I'm still gonna stick around 4-5 until I get like a good, like even just a pull of 4-5 quick and down like I did for 395. So I'm getting there. I got 395 last time, like on day 20 or something like that. But you can see on the video that the ball was falling apart. I mean, falling off my fingers. So I had to drop it back down. So I would say I wasn't able to lock out completely and then wait for like a few seconds before I go back down. It was just 1 second, I mean, not even once, half second up and down. But being able to pull it up there, 395 overhand is pretty big accomplishment for me in just 3 weeks that I've been doing this deadlift thing, like seriously. So, and recap, let's see. Yeah, it's been a while. I've done some fairly heavy load. It's just that some day you just don't feel it, and the same thing with squat, you just don't feel it, and you just go as heavy as your body allows you to do that day. So there's no way to think about trying to go crazy every day. Some day you'll feel better than another day, and that's what happened. And I think it was a good experience of deadlifting every day, and that too. I may just stop at day 30 and try to reduce it to 3 times a week, like I'm planning to do for the bench press as well. The reason why actually I'm thinking of reducing those is because I have so many other goals, like doing only all these powerlifting movements for every day. I mean, it's good. Don't get me wrong, but it take a toll on your recovery and the time that you have to spend efficiently on other skill work or exercise that you're doing. So that's why I'm just gonna, I think I'm 3 days away from 4 months for squat every day. Even after squatting every day, I'm still gonna be squatting every day, but I'm gonna reduce the intensity of the days, like to maybe 2 intense days or 3 intense days, and the other day it will just go for me just to squat for the sake of squatting. It doesn't have to be too heavy, probably fairly light, you know, something to get me going and knowing that I'm squatting. That's my plan. I may change, you never know. So that's my take on the deadlift every day. I think it's a very good movement, and it's gonna help me much on improving my squat and even my mid back, I would say, from doing just calisthenics and pull-ups, I've never really focused on pulling horizontally, like on the rows and everything. So You know, you all watch a train. Every style of training has the pros and they have cons. I just happen to like the body weight training, the calisthenics, which is a great way to keep it to keep in shape and to keep doing it pretty much forever. Because at some point you will have to fall back from the heavy weights. That's why while I'm still on top of my game, I'm gonna delve into pretty much anything I can touch in the powerlifting and maybe weightlifting. That's why you've seen I've been working on some front rack movement, working on my mobility, because it's still a movement that is hostile to me. I gotta get comfortable with. Then I'm probably gonna hire a coach or, you know, request some guidance to learn the technique of weightlifting. I'm eager to get into some snatch and stuff like that. It looks pretty cool, impressive, and looking dangerous. And I have a lot of respect for people moving that much weights at high speed, you know. So everything got to be pinpoint and perform and in a very, 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 very efficient and technical way. So, yeah. So I think that's about it for deadlifting every day. I'm liking it. I'm going beast mode and looking forward to break the 500 on the deadlift. I got a long way to go, but one day at a time, my friends. I'm just like you. I may have some God-given ability, maybe some say genetics, but I do bust my ass, and my job is to show you guys that it can be done. And it is what it is. You can do it too. That being said, I'd like you guys to leave some comments below and tell me what you guys are working on right now. I mean, what's your style of training? You know, so I just want to hear from you guys. Have an idea of who are the people that follow me, that take inspiration from me. And I just don't want you to see me as someone that's doing some badass stuff and that you will never be able to reach that level. I start somewhere too, and I don't have to go back and show you pictures of when I started or what I was able to do. Let's just keep it. I mean, let's just say that I had a fair level of athleticism, but I've never played any sport before, you know. And if you go, I mean, I was a nerd back then as well. So we'll talk about it later on in some video. I just want you guys to leave a comment and telling me what you guys training and what kind of topic you guys like me to cover in the near future. Because I want to start talking much more to the audience. You know, I'm trying to figure what I can do to help them out, because I know what I can do to help myself out, and I tend to forget that I can do a little more to help people out. So all right then, talk to you later, and be good to people. Bless you all. Everything is and will always be Gorilla Mode. Salutes. Peace mode.